So can you talk a little bit about how the Seattle Police Department has responded to the needs of the community over the last few months? And what are some of the issues that you're seeing around us in the city?
Sure, I'll be glad to do that. Let me tell you how it started for us. In early March, you know, there was the state of emergency and the governor's order that came out in that first week of March. And my team, who I cannot say enough about, really came together and stepped up in amazing ways. And the city did too, because none of us is in this alone. I mean, this is truly a collaborative effort. But in terms of the police department, we were trying to figure out this uncharted territory. We dealt with pandemics, you know, before, like the blue flu or the, bird flu and H1N1 and some other things, but nothing to this level. Nothing where we were, I had so many questions, many more questions than answers. So right away we knew that first and foremost, we really needed to make sure that we had the contingencies in place to take care of the officers. We can't do our job if we don't have the people there, our resources to participate. So right away they came up with a system, we call it the Red Cap system. It was a system where if you're experiencing any of the signs of exposure or you think you've been exposed, that you could log in immediately, write down what had happened, have a dialogue with the doctor who was on call 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, to address our own personnel and where they were. Additionally, we had to set up ways, you know, there's all the issues around social distancing and following the universal precautions, which is difficult to do in your agency that your whole job is contacting people. So we really had to work on how we were going to moderate that, making sure that the officers had good personal protective equipment that they needed in the field. So the gloves, the goggles, the gowns, and the N95 mask, and trying to secure them, those masks, as it was a whole citywide effort to do, because it wasn't just police, but it was police and fire and others. So making sure we had, you know, the equipment that we needed for officers to wear. And then looking at, okay, how are we gonna minimize exposure and risk to our employees? Because they have to come to work. They don't have a luxury. The frontline folks are staying home.